Hey folks, today I'm going to be doing a class on a topic that I know is a major headache for a lot of people out there. Today we're going to be talking about password management. And the solution that I'm going to recommend to all of you today is a piece of software called LastPass. Today I'm going to walk you through this entire piece of software, including how to import your old usernames and passwords, how to use LastPass's software to change your passwords to make them more complex, and I'm even going to show you how to create an emergency contact so that, God forbid, if something were to happen to you, one of your loved ones has the ability to get into everything. In many ways, this actually makes LastPass work a little bit like a digital will. There is a 30-day free trial, and if you decide you want to continue on beyond that, it's around $2 a month depending on what type of license you need. How to manage your passwords with LastPass, coming up next on Tech Talk America. The first thing you're going to want to do when you go to LastPass's website is you're going to click on this little button that you see right here that says Get LastPass Free. From here, you'll be directed to install the LastPass web browser extension. Now, if you do use more than one web browser on your computer, you're going to want to do this for each of them. If you need links to any of these, you'll find them all down below in the description of the video. This feature is just going to allow LastPass to synchronize across your various devices. So now that the web browser extension is installed, you'll see that I have the little LastPass icon here at the top right. It's gray because right now I'm not signed in. When it is active, it'll be red. For now, let's click on it and let's create a brand new account. You can also see that this is where you can go to sign in if you're installing it on another device. For now, let me type in my demo account email address and let's click create an account. At this point, you are going to be prompted to create your master password. And when everything is said and done, this is really the only password that you will need to remember. Now, depending on what your security needs, you can either make it so that you have to enter in this master password every time you use LastPass, or if you want it to be a little bit more lax, I am going to actually show you later on how to make it so that you don't need to enter in this password quite as often. That's coming up soon. Now that LastPass is talking to your web browser, for those of you out there who are Mac users, I would recommend that you do one other step and go into the Mac App Store and download the LastPass app. That way, if you ever need access to this kind of information, you don't have to go through the web just to get it. And after you're done with that, you might want to consider putting a shortcut to the LastPass app down in your dock. Just go into your Applications folder and you can drag it and drop it wherever you like. Now, let's open that app and let me log in with my username and password that I just created. And I want to point out that here you will see that we have two options that may be a very good option for people who just need their Mac to be a little bit easier to use. You'll notice that we have an option here to have it remember both your email address and your master password. Obviously, this is not something that you want to use if you are using your computer in a shared work environment, but for some people, this is going to be a very handy feature. So I wanted to make sure I pointed it out. Once you've installed LastPass into your iPhone or iPad, there's something that you're going to need to change in the settings to allow it to communicate with your iPhone. So now let me show you how to do that. You're going to first go here into Settings. Now this is of course after you have already installed the LastPass app from the App Store. From here, scroll down a little bit and we're going to go here into where it says Passwords and Accounts. From there, Autofill Passwords. And just make sure that top option is turned on and make sure that LastPass, which you see right there, is checked. When it comes to importing your data, it all depends on how you are currently storing that information. For those of you who are using a different password saving application, you can probably export it and import it into LastPass. In order to do this, just log in through the web to your account, go to More Options, from there, go here into Advanced, and from there, the very first option is Import. Here you can see a list of all of the other types of password saving applications that do talk directly to LastPass. But if you're saving your passwords through another method, you may end up having to import them manually, which I'm going to walk you through right now. So I'm going to just open up my web browser. And what's going to happen is as we start to log into various websites, it's going to automatically start to save the information. And then we're going to use the password generator to change the password to something a bit more complex. So let me log in at this point with my real username and password. And you'll notice that when I now go to sign in, before I do see the LastPass icon right here. But because it's the first time I've used it, it doesn't really know what to do. It doesn't see any information. However, in the future, that is what we're going to end up clicking on. Just wanted to point that out now. So let's hit sign in, and I'll show you what happens. And as you will see here, we get a little alert that pops up at the top right. And just by simply clicking add, we can now add that info to our LastPass vault. Now, keep in mind, this is truly only the first part of this process because from here, what we're going to want to do is change that password to something that is just a bunch of random letters and numbers. So I'm going to go back to that website at this point and go in to change my password. Now, because that password is stored in my LastPass vault, what I can do at this point is click on that little icon here over at the right-hand side, and then from there, I can just simply click on where it says fill, and it will fill that password. Now, when it comes to creating a new password, check this out. All you need to do is secondary click. Some of you know that as a right click. And you will see that LastPass now appears here at the bottom. So from here, you'll notice that we have an option to generate a secure password. I'm going to check that. And from here, we can choose exactly how complex we want this new password to be. Now, if I could give you one little piece of advice, for something like a website where it's just going to autofill in the future, you can go really as complex as you want. But for other types of accounts like your Apple ID or maybe a Netflix password, anything where you might actually need to type out this password manually, you might want to keep it a little bit more simple. So when you have your password created, we're going to click on the little red button here at the bottom right that says copy password. And from here, I'm just going to paste it into these two fields with Command V. And you'll notice when I click the change password button, we get a little pop-up notification at the top right from LastPass telling us that our password has been updated. So for those of you out there who store your passwords through a manual method, you're basically just going to need to repeat that process for all of the various websites where you have accounts. I'm going to show you how to create secured notes and add your credit cards into LastPass and all sorts of other good stuff. But before we get to that, there's a really important feature that I wanted to show you, which is how to create an emergency access contact. This is what I referred to at the beginning of the video, where this application can really act almost as a digital will. So let me show you how to set this up. Here at the bottom left, we're going to go into where it says emergency access. And on this next screen, you'll see we have two categories, people I trust and people who trust me. So when you set up emergency contacts, you will see these various people listed in this area here. So for now, let's go down to the bottom right corner and hit that little plus button. Now at this point, I would just need to type in the email address of my emergency contact. And below that, you'll see there's this feature here called wait time. Let me explain how this feature works. If my emergency contact requests access to my account, at that point, LastPass will send me an email letting me know that they've done so, and a timer begins at that moment. And in this case, after 48 hours, if I don't respond, they will gain access to my account. So with that knowledge, choose whatever wait time you like. In some cases, I can totally understand why someone would probably want it to be immediate, but you can also have it be as long as 30 days. Getting back to where we were, you'll also notice that here in LastPass, you can add secured notes. You can add as many as you want. If you'd like to add a folder structure, you can do that. Just hover over the little plus symbol here at the bottom right. You can add folders if you like. Also, you're going to probably want to go here into addresses. More than anything, you just want to add yourself here. So when you go to fill out forms online, it can fill this information very quickly. So just put your information in there and hit save. Also, of course, we have the ability to store your various credit cards here within LastPass. One little piece of advice I learned years ago that I would like to pass on to you Here in the notes section that you see of the credit card, I would recommend that you put the customer service phone number. That way, God forbid, if you're ever robbed and the robber's too dumb to not take your cell phone, you have a way to contact your credit card company rather quickly and tell them to obviously put a stop on all charges. By putting all of your credit cards here in LastPass, what it means is that when you're on the web and you need to submit that kind of information, just like we were able to do with your username and password, you'll be able to secondary click, and under LastPass, that will be one of the options that you'll be able to submit. I know this is slightly off topic, but while we're on the topic of credit cards, I do want to mention that I tend to recommend that you consider also registering each of your credit cards with Apple Pay. The reason is, even if you don't use Apple Pay, that way, anytime there is a charge on your credit card, you'll get a push notification on your iPhone, Apple Watch, and whatever other devices that you have it registered with. Finally, you'll notice that we have a little section here for bank accounts, so that way you just have a really fast, easy way to get to that kind of information. Here's the different fields that you have access to. So there you go. Once you have finished the process of importing your usernames and passwords and have also changed those passwords to make them more secure, the other thing you might want to consider doing is printing this information so that you do have a physical copy. This can be a very handy thing to put in something like a safe or a safety deposit box. In order to do this, go to the web extension icon here at the top right. Go here to where it says More Options, and you'll find that the last option here is print. Thanks for watching, everyone, and keep in mind, if you ever want to take a private lesson with yours truly, that is something that I like to do when I have a little bit of free time, especially in the winter. If you would like to find out more information, you can find out everything on my website and even book online at techtalkamerica.com. Just go to the little page called Private Lessons. This is David A. Cox with Tech Talk America. Class dismissed.